down. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They run for the first time with Ty Chandler. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down. The Panthers at 2-1 now to start the campaign, and they move back above 500 with a victory last week.
And you look at their start, a win, a loss, then a win. This might be something we see from them a lot this year, because when they're at their best, they can play with anybody. But bringing their best every week, that's been a challenge thus far.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I don't see Morgan trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Chandler on second down. And this defense able to plug him up there as he'll get a yard to the 35.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On third down, he'll drop the throw. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 45-yard line. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So now first and 10 as they crossed into Miami territory at the 45-yard line. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flash down right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Credit the sack to the safety, Jesse Bates.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. A long way to go here on third down for the 8th play of the drive. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And he's going to get this down near the 25. They go play action here on first down. This is caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it with an eyelash. Dropped at the one. That one goes for 24 yards.
Look, he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape for first and goal.
Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football. As they go to work on a first and goal. They'll try and run the option left side. And he is going to lose yardage here. What you pray? Second and one. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others. Where do they think they have an advantage? And dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Ball again on second down. Works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage and mixed traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big time play?
That's the tight end, Hurst, with it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. That gain of 9 buys them a new set of downs. On first and 10, it's Hall. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
That was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning it a big way and getting their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From the 44, Lawrence. And he fires one that's intercepted. And the Panthers are going to take possession as they got it at the 22-yard line. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback rolling left and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
Not good, and we saw the result. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 15-yard.
Y'all just catching on late, speaking on my personal life, my real life, but my head is fake.
There's people that wake up and go
get paid dope.
Ain't no caps, I never did none. Photo course, so photogenic. All I know is
niggas
to go
end up dead, cause I got bitches laid back. Ain't got no time.
All I know is to go get it.
It's all fed, I'm all that he say, she say, cold red, none to a granddad. Without time, I'm gonna be
go get it.
Have arrived as we are inside a soggy Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Today it's week four, and we've got what should be a great one here between the Miami Dolphins and the Carolina Panthers. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. They go play action with Lawrence. And his first pass is incomplete. Well, that's not the way you want to start a first pass attempt and a first drop.
Well, you got plenty of time to make up for it, but obviously not the way you want to get things started. Got to shake that off and get going.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
You said what?
And before the second down play,
need my points in the ball yet.
Timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here
what?
In this first quarter.
Nigga, it was 6-0. Pump me the ball.
And now it's second down, but here's the field goal team out onto the field. Oh, this is going to be fielded defensively. And remember, this is a live football. Pass midfield. Look out. And he will get this into enemy territory. A great return there on the missed field goal. This offense got to be loving this. After the long missed field goal, they'll take over on the other side of the 50.
Well, first move
and 10.
Them off dead. Move them off digs, bro.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just to
move him away from digs.
Just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And the Panthers are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Well, they told us that he was just going to be a bear to defend. And usually tight ends are, Charles, but he's no exception to that rule. His second catch of the opening possession, and it gets him a first down.
Yeah, and they certainly saw something on his earlier reception. He went back and reported what he found. And one of the things about him, he's like a wide receiver to me, Brandon. He has a great sense of spin.
And he takes it into the end zone for the Panthers' touchdown. A great effort there. With a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the
play your game.
And the Panthers will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. Looking for a seam, but finding none. They get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Officially, no gain on the play in that second game. This defense for the Panthers, they were terrific a week ago in the win over Washington.
And every defensive team that we talked to, they spent a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And it's only a two or more a game. You got a really good performance.
The free safety rolled all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust the back and figure out it's not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make it?
But it's not going to be crazy, but it's funny. Cannot move like
around the first thing to catch. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the ball.
And he had a tough game, and the head coach said, I'll take it, I'll fix it. The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, he's yours from now on. Someone has to take responsibility and work with him and try to get him settled.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early, and that's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive, and now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as he drew it up in practice.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now a handoff to Chandler. There on the tackle, Mika Fitzpatrick.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still, a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
The run got four, now they deal with a second and 6. They'll keep it himself, and they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. And he'll decide to keep this once more. And oh, he coughed it up. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
That's probably bringing back nightmares of last week, isn't it?
No doubt about it. Right now, I'm looking over at the coaching staff, and I'm seeing the wheels turning in their heads. And you know what is happening? They're remembering how they started the season in camp, even in the offseason where they emphasized ball security. And they're wondering why the message isn't sinking in.
They have 5 turnovers last week, now 1 here in the opening quarter. Now Lawrence on first down. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give you unsolicited advice. Just throw it downfield out of the pocket, only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try to get those yards a safer route.
And not a whole lot there, maybe a yard to the 27. Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Not that down for a win when the defense is tired.
Here's Lawrence. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free. It's fourth down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. And I think the ball's out. And the offense will recover, but it won't make much difference here. This will still be a turnover on downs. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And Diggs has it. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago. Followed up with another nice one here. And before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Stephon Diggs from 8 yards out. And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And he put the pass in on the good. And that'll make the score 14-0. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Drive. And this is not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements. You're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish or where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try to put some pressure on the defense.
Straight ahead is Hall, and the running lanes non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Off the play fake, here's Lawrence. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively as they sack him for a loss of 9.
Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation because with that type of a lead, it felt like they could take a few more chances and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game. It's not the first time they've gone his way on this drive, and they were obviously keyed into it because they were there to help break that pass up.
Fourth down, here's Lawrence. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Now Lawrence. And that's going to be caught. T. Higgins. And they'll wind up giving this one all the way down inside the 20. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he's left with no option here but to throw away.
His defense is going to have to finish the job. We're still a second half. Do they have to play?
But so far, an absolute total effort. They disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into air throws. Everything they're doing, they executed well.
They're going to play action now. Lawrence. Throw left side, caught by the tight end, Hurst. Touchdown for the offense. And Hurst, his first touchdown of the year. And the Dolphins have cut it back without a score. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that'll make our score 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field. They will send this one away. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
That is caught. It's the tight end Gatter. And he will be taken down, but a big play there as it comes just as we reach the two-minute warning. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. So as they take it over, we step aside. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now they'll run the option to the short side left.
I can tell you what I'm worth for you, but search it though.
Wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. From back at the 4, here's second and goal.
Summertime like the hood having curses. I ain't never lied in my purse. I ain't never lied when I'm marching.
4 yards there on the keeper, but still going to bring up a third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Well, the ball mere inches from the white line on third and goal. They're going to look to throw. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Here we go.
He'll look to throw. Take it across the Panthers touchdown. Their mobile quarterback with his third touchdown of the game, number 15 of the year. And the Panthers' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. An extra point by Carlson, up and good. And it's now 21-7. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Taken from about the 12. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Ain't nobody gonna play with me, bitch, I'm fighting it.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now. Lawrence hit him, the ball is free. But it's picked up by the Panthers. We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side. A little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you are closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
I'll give them credit winning that first snap and forcing an incompletion. They're hoping that'll deflect the offense a little bit if they took the field charged up after taking over after a turnover.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He'll take a shot to the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. On play action, they'll throw. Diggs crossing the field and bringing it in. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. This is caught. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Jared Wilson from 17 yards out. And the Panthers will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Extra point by Carson. Up and good. The lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Marty, they're going to continue to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
This is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play at halftime. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with a pressure. Maybe that was for the best as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So we reach halftime of what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis, our Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Now the ball comes loose, and this is picked up by the Dolphins. That gutsy call there, he ends at the locker room with a lead, trying to get an inside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the game was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. Oh, dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Well, Carter, they've certainly played up to the top 10 defensive ranking this week. They've stifled this opposing offense throughout this game. This contest is now lopsided because of their efforts, and they're still a quarter to go.
Throwing again on second and 10. Lawrence. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
There's another step. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
On third down, Lawrence. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Adam Darby. And the Panthers are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder,
the Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play, but found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
And he's going to keep this again. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. The keeper gets him 7 that time, and it'll lead to a third down. A little do-it-yourself run right there. What a nice game.
I like that he knew that that was about all he was going to get. So he did a nice job protecting himself, took care of the football, took what the defense gave him. If they continue to allow him to do that, they'll find their way taking what they can all the way to the end zone.
Out of the gun now on third down. Flush to his right. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Trying to get away, but could not. And the defense coming through on third down. A loss of 7 to bring up 4.
I think this is where we see how the game has moved along a little bit. Free safety, no blitz, but reads the play, has no responsibility in coverage, and takes a gamble and goes against the quarterback.
Well, is that a spot that when he's coming, the quarterback needs to be able to find somebody, or not necessarily?
Has to, because with that amount of time coming from the free safety position, someone should break open.
They'll try and throw for it here. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off, and it'll be a turnover on downs. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively. It's a sack in for a loss of 9. On second down, a run with Hall. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Well, that's the third interception for Lawrence. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
That's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got Bioski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
They go play action here on first down. Buying time, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Dancing to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
I see the surprise in the first there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
We
a chance of wasting this great starting field position. A real threat. This is third and long. Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
He'll drop to throw. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. And the Panthers turned away on fourth down. And the Dolphins' defense is able to hold. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him
down. I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
This pass out wide to Hall. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Caught that one for me there, Parker. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football. Now, for those who missed it, he had an interception last week, too. When a lineman picks a ball off once, it's news. Back-to-back weeks, it's breaking news.
Look out, ladies and gentlemen. Big man with football. How about that? And look at, you know how happy he is right now? He's going to go to the defensive box room and practice this week and say, guys, I'm joining the ranks.
He's a pig in mud. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And these are the situations that really test the defense. Those sudden changes. They're already inside field goal range to start the possession. Their goal now, keep it to a long kick if indeed they end up trying one.
And the ball is knocked out. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And this is brought all the way back. A fumble recovery and take it to the house for a Miami touchdown. Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
Again, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
Well, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. As they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from the other team, that their drive and will to come back and hit can be taken to another score.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, it's here right there on the brain. I'll put a bag on your head, I'll put a bag on your face. If you ain't got a ticket, I'll put you up in the ring. I want to go in the club if they let me in with the rest.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The sack coming from Big Dalvin Tomlinson.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen. But somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking the lead. Thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste a super performance from these ace pass rushers.
Second and 13. Going deep for Diggs. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
The Panthers on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is going to be third and 13. Looking to throw. And that is incomplete. Critical play in this football game because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. And the Dolphins are right back in this football game.
Well, it certainly felt like he was going to challenge this defense no matter what. And he stepped up and tried to throw it to the outermost edge of the zone coverage. And they were more than ready for him. The problem now is if they are limited in what they're doing throwing the football, they got to figure out how to move it without being able to throw it to the outside and throw it downfield.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. I think you and I were a little surprised back later in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. They'll look to throw here on first down. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. And to me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Going deep for Diggs. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the line.
Yeah. Street women. You know. Gang's only, man. You know, we bring this dude out right next to the buttons and all. You know. Gang got it.
Southside. there, but it'll be third down.
Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
They'll look to throw again. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick.
And the Dolphins are right back in this football game. Throwing now, Lawrence on first down.
And now here's another interception.
It's Tariq Castro Fields who picked it. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, all I can do up here is just shake my head. I mean, six interceptions. I cannot imagine what he's thinking between the ears right now.
Well, just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated. If you're a receiver, you're thinking to yourself, any ball that's in the air, you become receiver and defensive back. You've got to go compete for the ball so that you don't get another one picked off.
They'll start out here with an option left. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. They'll be back at the 36. Here we go on second and 12. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play, forcing him to try and throw through contact and short of the six.
And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him about the 28. They'll look to throw here. Eluding the pressure right. He's got the hook up with Diggs. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. They'll set up a throw, rolling to his right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Well, no surprise there. He was looking for one of his favorite targets again as soon as he left the pocket. But the coverage was good downfield. He got right to the receiver.
It's my play, but I hate something. You were looking for a ring so that you can hate something. You can't keep all of that ball in. I wish I would say something.
They really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. They'll decide to keep this once more. And they'll be driven back to the losing yardage to the 9. They'll set up to throw. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Stephon Diggs with career touchdown number 75. And the Panthers are looking to make it two straight.
I mean, that's sad.
This fourth quarter.
My legs down back in my bag. I hold up a
another touchdown to the air for them, and for this rookie quarterback at the helm, he has put them in a great position, Charles, to get the victory on this one.
He's out there taking charge. Every touchdown for them is done via his arm. Zero rushing touchdowns, no special teams, no defensive scores. All him throwing the football, he's a cruise control right now, and so is his team.
Boy, how should I die? How could I prevail? Tell Anthony with the whales, hell. Say you been through hell, bear. Sleeping in them sales, scary. I can't see the cemetery. Rather be preliminary. Then kill me voluntary. That's why everybody care. That's why everybody's scary. And my money fair. Me and Millie's married.
And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the 2-minute warning. They go back to the arrow here after the INT on the last drive. And my goodness, another interception. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football.
Cop hanging, arm slaying, watch flanking, block hanging, crooked like a wire hanger.
violate us neighbors. Everybody racist. Can't say everybody racist. Can't say everybody
racist. All up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Black men racist. Do they face killing kids. How you feeling? No, you killing kids. You was drilling. Now you swilling for you killing feet.
That one looks like he'll crawl here.
Tell them how you feeling. You kill the innocent, not your enemy. You.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't get a hook. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
They know how to chill. They're gangbang, 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 gangbang.
From the shotgun, he'll make the throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the
30.
On play action, they'll throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He's going to fire one, corner of the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Dolphins are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Now Lawrence. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side. And an inability to advance the ball from the other.
To throw again on second down. Lawrence, he's going to let it fly. And now here's another interception. Now the Panthers are going to take over the 12-yard shot in midfield. Without an interception, he just set a record. And nobody ever wants to set, and that's the most picks ever in an NFL game.
Might could have blew up my brain though. Must ain't got no aim no more.
let me in the ring some more. I found some gold and rainbow though. They say I got money to change the clothes. Don't think it, I'm still dangerous though. Still walk up on a stranger though. Gates running my veins for sure. I wanna change him though. Know how to channel my anger though. Oh, we ain't gon' stay. We're good if we go name though. Oh, yeah, I'm famous though. None of my killers won't pay me though. Oh, we don't supposed to be banging, no. Me and my we hanging though. Oh, I don't wanna be slanging though. Don't never stop ranging though. Oh, I don't panic. We'll be panoramic. I was selling dope for my grannies. See this, yeah, I need a Grammy. Need another big expansion. Big yard, big in the hammy. Wrist all way Atlantic. Big bucks, no whammy. My team, she baddest. This guy look like Angela. You know a young then ran it up. They hung about her fam, huh? Where'd it come from? That was random, huh? That's respect I demanded. I said broke down, Rick can't stand it. She heard what can't stand me, huh? Worth a couple mil, I'm branded, special cause I'm left-handed, huh? Name is, I had it. I ran through that sound like I must have forgot it. I helped out when I sipped all the patties. They think that's a lie, but they don't want no status. You savage, it should be no rumor, you ratted. I fought. So have me a favorite. You just didn't imagine. They pull on their blood just to see what we average. Bladders and horses and carriages. You know we clapping. I'll be embarrassed. Hey, we ain't gonna hop out no caravan. Hey, phone to my pal, your cameraman. Ay. Real street, I represent. Long live all the ones of me.
Intelligence to make it make sense. We gon' manifest whatever we came to get. That's a little money and a trophy and nothing. our respect. We don't care who the best, we don't worry who's next. We gon' put the boys to rest like I tell them to be the bed. I'm ahead of the rest like I came without a net. They gon' say it under breath, I'ma say it with my chest. I got it wrapped like a toga, put the whole team on my shoulders. Hold up, wake these boys up, call me Coca. Soldier, flow feeling colder, some call it Mola. You don't wanna box me, I'm feeling cocky. Hair stocky, leave him floppy, face Nazi. Talking all Aki, think he big poppy. Then I'll chop him down like a Rati. I see none of you here can stop me. It's obvious, you're too sloppy, cheap copy. I'm rocky, leave his eyes all glossy. But in the end zone is where you can spot when I touch down.
First off, let me talk my got a couple things I gotta cross off my list. How you insomniac for sleeping all my it's a bad soundtrack, read the script. Born in the motherland, headed straight down to the south. Tennessee mornings with pops, working three jobs. I knew that they struggled to get it, that's why I wanted to get it. That embedded, you get it, treat it like the law. And I'ma need commission for this hit. Lance laid the canvas and I painted over it. I don't need a vision board to show you I'm the I'm betting on myself. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest. Try to sink my ship like Titanic and leave me with Jack. Hope I be panicking, but I rose to the top. Isn't it funny that the is built like a Maserati, yoga folding like origami? What? I walk the walk. I talk the talk. I be saying what I want. When I had no deposit, closet was looking real bare. Now I made a deposit, my closet's looking super rare. Drove it really far. Crazy how did this happen, wishing on a star. It's a celebration, I ain't talking Mardi Gras. With a little patience, you'll be eating Budokan. What you want? What you want? Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest. Never let a man affect your stack like that. And if you're getting toxic, tell the boy fall back. If it was back then, I'd be tripping off that. Took a little time just to get me on track. I went from snotty to snobby, got it like, immune to everybody, this is stunt 101. Up in the club, throwing the 50s like, hated the love it, I just can't get enough. Labels keep calling me, I said move if you call me please. Or don't even bother me, they said oh my apologies. They keep calling and calling, I keep stalling and stalling. Rookie of the year, my career snowballing. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my life.